Well, welcome everybody. So good to be back. I wish I could see you in person, but we're going to do this for a while. And so welcome to our first summer program for school age. It's Full Steam Ahead, Adventures in Art. Sense Adventures in Reading is what we're doing. So one of the things I like to do, and if you've been in my programs before, you know, I really like to find things to do with common household items, things that we already have at home so that it's just kind of fun to put them together in new ways. And so today we're going to do make homemade art supplies. And we're going to do three different things. We're going to make Play-Doh, and we're going to make sidewalk chalk, and we're going to make watercolor paint. And it all came out of my kitchen cabinet with the exception of one thing, but it's easy to find. All right. So the first thing we're going to do today is we're going to make no-cook, and it's no-cook Play-Doh. There's a lot of clay and Play-Doh recipes out there that require cooking. This does require hot water, so if you're younger, you definitely are going to want mom or dad to help you with hot water to be safe, but there's no boiling or anything that goes on with this, okay? And we're going to mix it up in a baggie, so there's not even like bowls to clean, which is one of my favorite things. So you're going to want to measure pretty carefully. I have my ingredients already pre-measured, and it's going to require flour, salt, hot water, cream of tartar, which I actually have right over here, and a big thing because I like to use a lot of it. I usually make this with meringue, but today we're using it to make Play-Doh with. So you can find this in your grocery aisle. You probably have some in your cupboard at home if mom likes to cook. So a little bit of cream of tartar and some just plain vegetable oil. All right, so what we're going to do, I have a half a cup of flour already in here, and I'm just going to, I guess I can just use the same thing since I'm not using a bigger baggie. All right, and I have 2 tablespoons of salt. I love my portion cups. Just gonna pour it in. All right, try to mix it up a little bit. All right. Okay. And I'm gonna add my cream of tartar as I'm adding my dry ingredients, which is very much what we do when we're cooking. Very much if you've baked cakes and cookies, you know you usually put your dry ingredients in together and then mix your wet ingredients in. So my cream of tartar is going in. Again, a little bit. All right, I'm gonna do this. Oh, that's pretty good and mixed. And next, we're gonna add our oil. Very carefully take this off so I don't have a big oil spill here in the assembly studio. Drop that in. And then we're going to add 1/4 cup of hot water. I just took this out of my hot water pot, right? So I'm going to pour that in. Now, here's the thing. I like a little color in my Play-Doh, as I bet most people do, because white is fine, but I'm going to go for blue today. All right. I'm just going to add 3 or 4 drops of blue. Very carefully put the lid back on. I did not the other night. It was not good. Okay. And then we're just going to mix it up in here. My baggie. See how I do not have blue on my hands like I did the other night. Now here's the thing. You shouldn't have to add any extra flour to this. You know, it should be pretty dry when you pull it out, but just in case, because sometimes flour is, you know, some flours are a little bit drier than others, it seems like. I am going to just pull this out and I'm dropping it on a work surface. So don't do this just on a table. Put a little bit of like aluminum foil or wax paper or something out, or if you have a cutting board or something, just to kind of finish putting this up. The first time I did this in a slightly bigger Ziploc and it probably was a little bit easier to mix in. Okay, upside down. So there I have my big flue mess, but all I'm going to do is knead it. And you guys, if you've done pies before or anything, you know that kneading is just a good way to mix things up and make the dough smooth. And that's all we're going to do. It's just, oh, this is much drier than it was the other night. We're just going to, and you can see how I'm continuing to mix in the color. You can add more. I didn't add a lot of color to it this time, but you can certainly go back and add more if you want. It's food safe color. I'm just using regular food coloring. If you have Wilton's like gel color, sometimes that's a little bit brighter color. Might go back and pick up all of this stuff. And here it is. Just keep working it till it's nice and smooth. And then when you're done, you get to store it in a baggie and it will keep for a while. It won't keep forever. If you see a little bit of mold on it, throw it away. But it does have, obviously it's got salt in it, and salt is a good preservative, right? So it does tend to keep for a while. I've had the one I'm going to show you in a minute, I've had for over a week, and it has, and there I am. Right there, so you can roll it out and make fun little figures with it. It will air dry. Okay, this is the fun one I made the other day, and it's really smooth and very cold. I don't know why. It's not in the refrigerator. But anyway, it was very easy to make, super fun to do on a, one of those days when you're just kind of like bored and don't know what you want to do. Make a little bit of Play-Doh, and you can be very creative and artistic about it. And you remember, you can also practice your color mixing with this, because I know we almost all have these things at home. So if you go to the back side, you're also going to notice, you can do more than red, blue, green, and yellow. You can mix things up to make orange and purple and all kinds of things. Okay, so practice your color mixing skills as well. So that is the first one. Okay, let me clean this up just a little bit. So I'm not used to being on a small table. Walking and talking is what I do. Okay, so the next thing we're going to make is we're going to make homemade watercolor paint. Okay, so I made some the other day, and I did it in a couple of different ways. I actually put them in these cute little portion cups. So this one has a lid on it, and it is. Oh, actually, it's dried out quite a bit. I put the lid on it because I wasn't sure if I wanted it to dry. I wanted to try a different thing. And so I have my paintbrush, and I actually did bring, I guess, a sheet with me. So I'm going to try this and see. Oh, that's good. Yeah, it works. It's still pretty good. I just dabbed it with water. When I first started this, I was actually able to use it as soon as I made it. I just dipped my brush in a little bit of water. You can use a Q-tip too, and probably you could even use your finger if you want to. Everything in here is food safe. Well, maybe the powder piece. Don't eat it. Okay, but it should be okay to put on your finger if you want to do a little bit of finger painting. But it dries. So if I didn't leave the lid off of this one because I wanted to see how long it would go. So I actually made several of them. I did dry some. I put them in little cupcake liners and I let it dry overnight. And so you can see I actually tried to use the red one. So I just have to get your brush really wet, and it transfers quite well for that. So we're going to do that next. So I'm going to need, where's my paint? Right here. My paint color. We're going to need 4 tablespoons of baking soda. So I have baking soda. I have cornstarch. It's going to be 4 tablespoons of baking soda, 2 tablespoons of white vinegar. Vinegar, you notice that I didn't trust myself to bring it upstairs without banding it together, but white vinegar, 1/2 teaspoon of light corn syrup. It's like that. I don't think that maple syrup would work, but in a pinch, I might try it. It might be, flavored paint. It will take 2 tablespoons of cornstarch, and it will take some paint powder. Now that is dry paint. That's like just powdered paint. I have a little bit right here in a cup, and I'm going to show you. You can get this at most of the craft stores, Hobby Lobby, and definitely United Art and Education has these too, and you can order them online. So it's just like color tempera paint. So you just mix it with water and you can make your own tempera paint. But I like it too because when you want something that doesn't have a lot of water, like what we're making, we don't want a lot of excess water in it. Just being able to add the color is great. So we're going to use powder paint. Okay, so I need my cup. I'm So we're going to do, let's see, I'm going to add my baking soda. Sorry, I lost my place here for a minute. Which again, 4 tablespoons of baking soda. I'm just going to pour it into a cup. Okay, and then I'm going to add my white vinegar to the baking soda. Now, what happens when you mix vinegar and baking soda together? And I know you think I'm going to have a big explosion. So let's see. Because 4 tablespoons of baking soda, right? So let's pour the vinegar in. A little bit. That's actually bigger than less earlier. Usually it will bubble up to the top. So if you want to put it in a slightly bigger cup, you can do that. But I just had this one on hand and I wanted to use it and it's easy. So also I'm going to say when you're making any of these, please, like you'll notice I have a tray that I'm using. So yeah, definitely put down a work surface so that you don't have a big mess at home on your kitchen counter or your table. Okay. So I'm going to mix up my vinegar and my baking soda. Okay, and then I'm going to add this half teaspoon of white corn syrup, which is really sticky, very sticky. I'm just going to tilt it out, and I'm going to say I'm using a craft stick to stir, not even a regular spoon. All right, get that all out if we can. Mix that together. Then I'm going to add 2 tablespoons of cornstarch. Okay. Now, my instructions when I first was doing this said, when you mix it together, you should have a mixture the consistency of Elmer's glue. And I think the person who wrote that was mistaken. Because it's really not like Elmer's glue. And I'm going to tip it. Is this on overhead?
I'll switch it over for you.
Okay.
Yep.
I want to show you. It's not the consistency of Elmer's glue, particularly. It does pour. Let me pour it to this. It does pour a little bit like that. But if you have ever mixed water and cornstarch together, you know you get oobleck, right? And that is really what the consistency is. It's much more like oobleck than it is paint. So if you get that, don't panic, because the first time I did it, I thought that is not right, and I've measured wrong, but that is actually it. And now I'm going to add in my paint powder. And my paint powder is, let's do red. I haven't done red in a while. I'm just going to throw that in and mix it up. And it will be a little tough to stir. As a matter of fact, may break a stick or two here. Try not to. And I'm actually coloring the whole batch. The last time I did this, I really poured it into 4 small little pots and mixed it together. So it may be more like pink. So I would say if you want multiple colors, definitely divide it up like I have here. I have pulled, I divided into 4 and I actually had green, yellow, blue, and red. But in the interest of time, don't do that. Plus, how exciting is it to watch someone stand here and stir, even if it is oobleck. All right. So what you can do now, it's pretty well mixed. What you can do, let me use this one. Did I bring that? I don't think I put a little one out for me to use. So I'm just going to import this. So this one is a little bit runnier than was. So if you think it's too runny, you can also just add a little extra cornstarch to it. I may have had a little more vinegar than cornstarch because I think when I did it earlier, my vinegar might have evaporated a little bit. Also, if you want to make the paint pad like this, like the little, you can pour this in a muffin tin. Like a small mini muffin tin or a big one, and let it dry. To be honest with you, I put these in a muffin, just a muffin cupcake liner, and slid it in the oven about 200 for about half an hour the other night just to see if I wanted to hurry up and dry, because not the most patient person in the world. So you can actually pour some in here. then set it aside. And just let that dry. It will air dry. Or like I said, you might be in a hurry like me and want to dry it in the oven. You can put a lid on this. You can try using it immediately if you want, but like I said, it will dry and you will get something the consistency of this or this. Okay. Very usable. I said, I realized I painted a small picture the other day and then it's downstairs. Did not bring it upstairs with me. Whoops. Okay. So that is paint. Again, if you're bored and want something to do. Let me clean up because I am running out of space here. Here we go. Move this. Okay, so now we are down to, and that's just homemade watercolor. So now we're gonna do sidewalk chalk. Never made chalk before. I love plaster though. And we have done, if you've been in my class, you know that not too long ago we did an art project and we did frescoes where we used tempera paint on plaster that was just still wet, not totally dry. And we watched how the color seeped into the plaster, just like Leonardo da Vinci and Michelangelo used, right? So we're gonna do something with plaster that's not exactly like that, but we are gonna make sidewalk chalk. And this, I did two because I was just curious about the water. And no matter what Pinterest tells you, there's always something that's going to happen, right? So I used this piece actually was with the full amount of water. And to me, I mean, this look is over the weekend, so I never squeezed it like that before. So don't do that. You will not want to do that one. That one was with using all of the 4 tablespoons of water. When I tell you the recipe in a minute, you're gonna understand why. This one was half the water. It dried overnight. It's exactly the right consistency. I think this is what we're gonna go for. And I'll tell you too, it makes a difference probably on what mold you're gonna use. I just use like little Dixie cups because that's what I had. But if you have some cute little cookie cutters or you want to make your own mold maybe out of aluminum foil where you can make like a rant, you know, round, or you want to throw it in an old toilet paper tube or paper towel tube, because heaven knows we all have those right now. You can do that. So here's the recipe for homemade sidewalk chalk. You're going to take 3 tablespoons of plaster of Paris. Now you can find that at a craft store, but I'm going to tell you my local Meijer. Back in, and it was not in the craft supplies, it was back like in home goods, like where patching and joint compound and paint. That's the aisle this was on, and it's actually a little cheaper when you buy it from a place like that than if you buy the whole thing. But you can get, like I said, any craft store, Walmart, will have it, okay? So we're gonna do 3 tablespoons, and I'm gonna measure because I put quite a lot in here because we were gonna do 2 or 3. So I'm gonna measure, and you'll notice I'm just kind of brushing that off. We're gonna be fairly, do I have another cup over there? No, I've got one here. Okay, one, two, three. And I will show you, if you're pulling this out of a box, the other thing you can do, you notice I'm leveling off, you can just take a craft stick or a knife. It's exactly like we do when we're baking and we want to level something off. Just take a solid, a straight line surface and just scrape over the top, right? So that is 3 tablespoons of plaster of Paris, okay? And I'm going to do 2 tablespoons of my paint powder. That stuff is really coming in handy. So glad I had so much of it on hand. This is 2 tablespoons. I did pre-measure that, all right? And I'm gonna use yellow because I haven't done yellow very much. Okay, and I am gonna mix that up. And we're going to try to avoid having this happen and have this happen. Although it still looks like you could use it, mash it up and use it for color, I guess. I don't know. Okay, so it's all mixed up. And we're going to add, it says 2 to 4 tablespoons of water. So I am actually just going to start with 2, okay? You may want it to be a little not quite as thick, or you may want it. I would probably put at least two in. Okay, so there's one, two. Let's see how it mixes. Plaster is surprisingly like flour sometimes. It takes less water than other times. That is really not a very pretty yellow in the cup, is it? I bet on the sidewalk it looks great.
It looks like mustard.
It really does. Don't want to get this on this. I'm going to add just a tiny bit more, just because I think I want to be able to get it out of the cup a little better. Like I said, just add water till you get the desired consistency. I know, I love those directions in a recipe too, where it's like, I don't know what that looks like. But I wanted to be able to pour it out, okay? So that's much better. I'm going to take it, and again, I'm just using a cup, one, because when I get ready to take it out, all I have to do is just tear the cup apart, you know, and I just cut down one side and it pulled immediately out. No mess, no fuss. Okay, and I'm just going to do this. Pour it in here. And like I said, I did this the other day and I just let it set overnight. And then the next day it was like, there it is. Okay. And you can fill it up. Like I said, I just use this as 3 tablespoons. You could make more. You could do 6, double the recipe and make a whole big cup of it. I was just curious about how long it would take to dry, so I didn't make a huge batch of it immediately. And you might want to try that. You might, again, and you could also, once again, invest in your color mixing skills if you have different colors of powder paint and see if you can get like an orange without buying an orange. So I think that is what we're the 3 things we've done today. So we've made homemade Play-Doh, we've made sidewalk chalk, and we have made homemade watercolor paint. Okay. All the things except for the plaster you probably will not have, but you might have. And you know what? I've never used joint compound for this. Now that I think about it, that might be something to try. I will try that and let you know how that goes. So anyway, that is what we have today. I thank you so much for coming and for tuning in, and we've missed you. And it's just so good to see you, even if I can't see you face to face. It's just really, really good to see you. Plus, I guess we will see you next time. Okay, so while you guys are still on, what I want to tell you is don't forget, it is summer reading, right? Summer reading. I know it looks a lot different this year than it normally does, but that doesn't mean you can't read, and we encourage you to. It's a great summer to relax and read and have fun. So you can go online to our website, www.greenwoodlibrary.us/summer. Although you can get to it just from the regular site too. Sign up for summer reading. If you have an account already, you're good to go. Just go in. We are going to be reading 1,200 minutes. So we're counting minutes this summer. That's 20 hours. And for every 5 hours you read, you will win a raffle ticket as a it's it will be a virtual raffle ticket. All right. For a chance to win one of our bigger prizes, we have what is it, five? I think 5 prize packs. They're like pirates and all kinds of things. They're going to be great. I don't even know what's on mine yet because we're still putting it together, but I promise it'll be great. So be sure to go in, sign up 20 hours. You guys are all readers. You can do that standing on your head. You will also at 20 hours get a free book. One way or another, if we have to give it to you through curbside, we will manage that, okay? And also, you will win for every 5 hours a brag tag because we still have those this year as well. And I got some new ones. There's still prizes to be had. And like I said, we just kind of made it fairly simple this year with just the 20 hours. You are free to read as much as you want. We encourage you to, and you would win raffle tickets. Up through, is it 100 hours?
I do believe
I think it's 100 hours, right? So you can continue to read. A lot of you are, 100 hours is nothing for you to read in the summer. And that's reading between now, if you haven't already signed up, reading between now and July 25th. That's that last Saturday in July. All right. What else do I need to tell you? Oh, if you enjoyed today's program, don't forget next week at 4:30, we will be doing backyard science. That will be fun. We need Zoom or YouTube or whatever. Whatever is working, Miss Emily says. And I want to tell you, if you signed up, and obviously you did because you're on, if you have not picked up, we are doing STEAM Craft and Go kits every week. So everything I made today is in this pack, as well as the instructions and the recipes. And a nice little thank you and reminder to thank our wonderful sponsors, because they really have stuck with us through this summer. So Adventures in Reading Art. So everything is in here. You saw me pull all this stuff out of plastic bags. The only thing I think that I forgot to include is maybe one of the bigger cups. But the plaster is in here too, all right? And all the paint powder. So you should be able to make pretty much everything. Just add water. That's kind of it, all right? And maybe a little food coloring. Because I couldn't figure out, and I still haven't figured out, how to do liquid food coloring in a small amount without it being really messy. In a portable way, but we're working on it. We might figure it out yet. So don't forget to register. And stop and pick up one of these. We'll have a new set out Monday for backyard science. All right. I think that's it. So thank you guys so much. So good to almost see you, and we will see you next time. Bye bye.